Of course, I can say 5 cameras so far. I started my photography with very simple camera, Agfa 3. Just click and then close. Very simple camera. Then after that, I went for one hot shot. That is also from Agfa company only. And that is also another simple camera. Then I went in for point and shoot Sony camera. That's a quite good camera. Then later I bought aim and shoot 60x zooming camera. That is from Canon. Then recent past I got another camera, Canon 1DS Mark II. That's a very good camera. So that way I had some five cameras in my time. It's very interesting. I think it should be in 1978 when I visited first time Delhi. We have been going around a lot of places along with my friends. When I saw this sunglass in a shop, I don't remember the grading and all. We immediately bought. Probably at that time it may be costing around 40 rupees or so. Very costly as far as we were concerned at that point of time. Then it was very interesting that because it was hot summer in Delhi, so that way we were using that glass meticulously. And with that same interest, my friends also used the same glass for taking different photos. Of course, as I told you, the first camera, Click 3, took major part in taking these photos, and this sunglass was very much useful for that cool feel of that environment. Yeah, I remember. It was also almost at the same time of 1978-79. One of my friend had a different camera, probably would not be a branded one, which was purchased at New Delhi itself from the local shop, and it had some name in that. So that probably might have been coming in that film negative also. So that's what I remember with that, and some few photos were taken with that camera.
Negatives.
So at that point of time, when I got my first camera, as I told you, Agfa 3 and other film negatives and all. So for developing, we had a studio at Nannilam. Nannilam probably you must be knowing. That is in Tiruvarur district of Tamil Nadu. And we had a very small studio. Probably the total studio size was 10 by 10. He had dark room and all within that, with a front office in that. And the studio name, I remember, it was Regina. So that fellow used to take our film roll as it is, and he will wash it and show us the pure negatives, and which are all the negatives can be printed for use. Those things I used to tell him, that way he will do. And of course, as I told you, the place was Nannilam near Tiruvarur, no? So that place is very interesting place, has got some interesting moments. I got remembered since this question came, the studios. Of course, we had a very good theater in the sense it's a tent theater made of simple coconut tree leaves, and very big tent, and it will be there only for 6 months. The theaters will be there for 6 months, and for 6 months nothing will be there, and next 6 months it will come back. Like that only we had cine theaters at that time, and we enjoyed going to those theaters. Even it will have matinee with a lot of bright light from outside, and even we have seen the blankets of the manager from whom he will bring it and close it for darkness in the theater that way. And I had another studio, Kembu studio, at Tiruchi itself, Tiruchirappalli. That is also in Tamil Nadu. and I was working in BHL near Kimbo studio. So I had a lot of films got developed there also. And another point, the thing is, in BHL, when I was there, we had a separate developing studio for the people, amateurs of the photos, no? Photography as a hobby, no? So after taking photos, we used to go to that studio and we will pay around 5 rupees per hour and we will stay for 2 hours. Probably that 10 rupees was an big amount at that point of time. So we used to develop ourselves and they had some small instructions there, and there we used to develop our own films, and even making printouts, they had an enlarger inside. And whatever chemicals for permanently making it, and bromide sheet, and so few things I remember here and there. And some jellies used to be there, and that is there in water, and this photo will be sticked on to that. And that way, then we will hang the photos on the top. Those things I remember. It was an interesting period. And though we had some of the photos got developed from Regina Studio, Nanilam and Kembo Studio in that place itself, that is in Tiruchi, we developed our own photos, whatever you have taken from our camera, Aqua 3 and Hotshot like that. It was a very interesting period. Nanilam, as I told you, which is in Tiruvarur district in Tamil Nadu, is very favorite for me because I had my entire school days there only. And those days till 9th, I was there along with my grandpa only. My parents were in different projects of Public Works Department of the Tamil Nadu. So I was supporting my grandfather, even though I was doing first standard, second standard like that. My grandfather had me as his, of course, helping hand, and myself was along with him. And he was working in a temple as a priest. And every day, you know, very interesting, and every day I will be sleep in the temple itself, and he will carry me on his shoulders when coming back to his home. The home was very simple. And it had tiles of old railway tiles like that. And you can find, even while raining, no, you will see waters inside, like rain only, it will also drop inside. Like that, a very simple hut-like house only. So from that house only, I was going to school and all. And it was Board High School in Nanilam, where I did my schooling. And it was that school is famous one way that our great director Balachandra also had his initial studies there. School fees, of course, was very, very low, and which was very high to our this thing. It was around 5 rupees, 10 rupees in that scale only that time. See, in school, it was to be very, very interesting. My the compound of the school corner was very near to my home. I remember one incident that people were telling my friends. See, you can just jump out of the compound so that you can reach your home within a few yards like that. No, once you get onto the wall, no, that fence, you can see the house in front of you, just some 10 meters, 15 meters. That way I thought that I would do that. Somehow I pulled onto the fence and jumped out. I saw my teacher there itself, who was walking towards his home. Immediately, no, I didn't know how I got jumped back into the school. So I think that much energy I was having on seeing my teacher that time. So got back like that. Few incidents I remember. I had some 15 tops. You remember? Pambaram we used to say in Tamil. 15 numbers, no? Some of my friends will casually take it away from me. I will have only one. Then I will find it in the street that they are playing, and I used to bring it back from them by crying and all. My house, no, till my 9th standard, I had only a simple chimney lamp, no electricity that time. So that chimney, if you slightly tune up, I will find as if I switched on the tube light what we have. I think we have come up to LED lamps and different kinds of lights. That time we didn't even thought of that. We didn't have no radio, and I never heard about radio at that time. Probably that was there in Panchayat Board office, where everybody will assemble for hearing the news at evening 6 o'clock, morning 6 o'clock, and mid-time 12 o'clock. People used to walk towards the Panchayat Board office, where there will be one radio. From that, a very big camera, you will find a camera like this, no? So that will be giving, not camera, it is a speaker. It was a speaker. That used to produce sound of the news and all. And people used to stand there, some 10 or 15 people will stand there and listen to the news and go back home. That was one interesting this thing. And hair cutting shops, that is also another very interesting thing. Parents are very strict that these small guys should have a proper marked one only. They used to even mark with chalk over head. So below that, no, there should not be any hair. That's how we had our days of hair cutting in shops and all. They used to put a small piece of wood over the normal table hands. And there we will sit and they will do the things like that. It was also interesting. Of course, while going to school, we carry a lot of small sweets. So sweets we used to have in small drawer itself. And we didn't wear any chappals and all for school. So that is also... And we chew it and have it on hand itself. So hands, you know, you can imagine how the hands will be. With that only we'll be handling notebooks and things like that. And we always be with a lot of dust and things only for the whole day. That's how it has been going on in Nanilam. Nanilam, we had a good temple. And another very big one, Shiva temple was there. We used to go there, and in our board high school ground itself, a very big ground, and we used to play there. And I had in the initial days music competition, there I used to get some prizes. And drawing, of course, one of my passion, fine art, that is using pencils or your color, watercolor brushes and all. Those things I could buy from one of the shop. We used to say that shop name as Mapilaikuppam shop, like that. That fellow was from Mapilaikuppam, was one of the places nearby Tiruvarur. So that way we used to call them as the name of the place and his name, like that shop wala. And there we used to get this color and all. We don't think of the poster colors what is available nowadays. That's a simple color with a cake like that, and they will have only one brush in that, and with that only we had some painting and all. And that's very interesting, because that was the initial day of developing myself on passion of drawing. And music competitions, whatever we had in school, I had some little prizes on first or second like that, standard wise. And teachers, of course, I cannot forget any of the teachers there. And mathematics teachers and all, fantastic. And even I remember one name, Arumugam, who was the English teacher, who was the of course principal of the school. And he only told us first time that English grammar is almost equivalent to mathematics in scoring in English paper. And he taught us very nicely tenses and all, whatever is there in English. And we used to get like that, no? He will say, once this is known to you, you are having that much marks in your packet. Like that he used to explain how to get, say 25 marks will be covered in that English paper. All of us, but the person from very poorest or the person who cannot understand anything also will answer in such a way that he gets 25 out of the total marks, that grammar portion. So that way we had very nice days in Nanilam. I'm happy of expressing that I was from Nanilam. When I was telling about Nanilam, no, where I had my school days and all, forgotten to tell you an interesting point, that is about the sweets, of course, sugar candies and all, which I used to get from school itself, due to various reasons, probably functions or friends' birthday, who will, normally those time, no, unlike chocolates we use now, those days and all, simple candies, for a rupee they will give you 20, 30, like that. So that I used to bring to my home for my sister, brother who used to come here and there along with my parents. So that I will keep in my hand always. So how the condition would be, you just think it over in the evening one night. But they will be waiting for me. I will bring something for them. That was very, very interesting, affectionate sisters and brother I had. And we spent a very interesting time that way. And another point I would say that, say I was knowing Nanilam, and maximum travel in those school days I have done up to Tanjore, not more than that. I didn't think that throughout my life there is going to be a lot of places which I would be doing in my time. See, after Nanilam, no, after schooling, colleges and all, I joined Bharat Heavy Electricals of Tiruchirappalli. And of course, I had lot of tours. That only I told you, no, I bought this Agfa camera at Delhi. So that was my first place of visit to Delhi. Then to Kanpur. Kanpur nearby, one Panki is there. There was one Bajrang Bali, that is the Hanuman temple. And there we have seen a lot of things. And many places like that in West Bengal, almost most of the power stations I have done, gone through. And then after that, Bhubaneswar is Puri, Jagannath and all. So I didn't think that at the time of schooling, I never thought that I would be visiting all these places in my lifetime. And to my surprise that my daughter got married and she has been put up in Canada. And there also we had gone 2-3 times along with my wife. Who is also from Tanjore. So that is one interesting that from Nanilam, a small village where I told you, know that only chimney lamp I used to have for my study days. From that point to joining BHL and retiring as deputy general manager and heading the training camp itself, that is the training center itself for technical and non-technical training. So all those things are the latter part of my life, which I had no thought that I would be doing all those things in my latter part. That way I got retired 3 years back. And so this is one of the interesting point that from Nanilam to Canada. Of course, I am settled down now at Srirangam. That is also nearby Tiruchirappalli, one of the auspicious place for Lord Ranganatha. So this is what I thought I would express in addition to whatever told sometime back. This is about my very first camera. It is Click 3 from Agfa company. See, there was a big imagination about photography at that time. I didn't think that time that I would be buying a camera, but for the budget of that time, no, I had only 180 rupees as my stipend when I joined BHL, and then we have been going around to New Delhi and all. And with that 120 was my mess fees at Delhi for the entire month. And with the balance, of course, BHL also paid 20 rupees per day for managing our food and all that time. It was 1978, I told you, no? So, with that packet money and all, we went to New Delhi. In local market, we bought this Agfa 3 camera. Click 3, the name given in that camera was Click 3. And that camera is very interesting. See, you will find normally in any camera, when you shoot, no, there will be a lever for pressing it and releasing it, no. There is no question of releasing it and all. Once you press it, it take, the aperture will open and take the photography. Okay. But in that camera, no, it had another feature. When you press, you can keep pressing it as long as you want. Like we used to have the British time photographers, no? They used to have one closed this thing and then he will open the front box and keep it for some time and then close it again like that. This Click 3 had one opportunity that you can open it and then keep it for some time and release it. And that option also was there, I remember. And another point was, unless you roll it for the next snap, or even you can roll it for half of it, the previous frame whatever you have taken and the new frame partially, both can be exposed for the next photo. Those feature was there in that. And you can roll it fully also, or on the same photo itself we can again take a photography. So that gave me some new thought in that. What I did, I had a black screen, and in front of that I used to put my sister on one side, and another half, if you see, no, it will be pure black, no. So I'll take first snap as if she is offering something to somebody, and that is the first photo. And the next photo again she will be put onto another side. I'm not rolling the film. It is there in the same position. So the same sister will sit in opposite side as if she receives whatever was given earlier in the previous snap, and she herself will receive the same thing. She will show her hand. Almost I will have a marking of where her stand, her hand has to stand at one particular point, so that it is seen that she is receiving the same from the same person, like that. Double acting, what you see in movies, no? Double acting. So that's how I used to take some tricky shots in that, and same person on both the sides. And even three times and all I have tried. Three people, all of them are same only. That's how I have tried with that. Though it was a very simple and low cost camera, I had a very interesting period with that, the capacity, whatever it had. I cannot say it is its capacity, probably that is it. It had the inferiority that you cannot lock the thing and all rolling. So but that was used for doing like this. Of course, Click 3 was my first camera, and when I got married in 1981, the total function, entire function was taken only from that camera. All of them were in black and white. And interestingly, I only, in my capacity, I developed all those things and made printouts also of that. And that's what I remember. And my entire tour at that time from BHL to New Delhi, that Panki site and Ennur power station near Chennai, and Panki was nearby Kanpur, and wherever we went, and of course from New Delhi we went to Varanasi, Kasi at that time, 1978, that was also interesting tour. So all those areas I had lot of photos only from this Click 3 camera. So I cannot forget that camera, that it occupied my early stages of life, and it was giving me lot of enthusiasm with respect to camera and how it would be in future like that. Of course, that probably the reason how my son is having a lot of passion over taking photography and all, probably. That's what I feel on that. And I'm happy expressing all these things with respect to my first camera. Thank you. I had been doing with this camera, no? As I told you, Oppo 3. So for quite a long time I have been doing, it might have gone up to 1 or 2 years, and I got married also in 1981. And in between, many of my friends had very good cameras, SLR cameras, and they used to take care of whatever to be done while on tour or during friends' marriage, wherever we go. They used to take some photographs and all. And with respect to passion I had, I would say little passion on that because of the curiosity of how he takes the photo and how, what is the result of it. And even probably when I was going to Delhi, I used to poke myself, my head outside the train. And when the train burns and that also, I used to take some photographs like that. No, I had some interest in that. And probably after joining back from all those tours and all to BHL back, I was given a different assignment on computer side. Then that time Fortran was occupying entire space in BHL for doing all engineering calculations like that, no? So my passion got diverted into programming side, and that way I didn't find time also in the evening or in the morning. I used to come 7 o'clock late, and even I used to carry the work to my home for doing all those official requirements. That took my major part of my life, leaving away from many of my hobbies, even say doing paintings, drawings, and using camera, and all those things got slightly disturbed because of my official life. I got married in 1981. Immediately next year I had my son, and very interesting time that I have spent with him. His younger days, we have been playing like anything, and with his sweet days. So that way, you know, totally life got diverted into a different focus area, where more of official, I would say, that than even taking care of the family. I have spent many time on official work. So that has fallen all this, my passion, if you say passion on photography, yes, that got diverted. And passion on fine arts, drawing, painting and all. And even on Sundays, I used to go to office for that sake. So that way, you know, I got diversion towards my official work only. Got transferred to Ranipet, which is nearby Vellore, that is also nearby Chennai. From Tiruchi, I went there, and I had been working there for quite long years. So entire period I was in computer systems area and engineering computer side, and materials computing. All those things occupied many of my personal life portion also, because of the workaholic nature in those area. So I think I would say there is a major reason that which I could not continue with all these things. And though I bought camera and later said probably this aim and shoot camera I mentioned some time back, and point and shoot camera and all, I bought only in the later part of my life when my children got full growth and they started working. And that time only I had little time, and I was out of that all those system oriented area. I got into training where people used to work and I used to execute work from them. So that I had some time to do, spend on these things. So and as I told you, I went to Canada and done for my daughter. No? So that time I used cameras and taking outside photographs. So otherwise early days, the total diversion from that was main reason was my official involvement and my own workaholic nature at that time. I think that took away many of my portion, even concentrating on my children, and all those things got affected because of that. That's what I feel sometime later, that I could have balanced all those portions. I have my own slight guiltiness over it. But anyway, gone is gone. Now, this thing is, nowadays I feel free now after retirement. I do some photography, I do some paintings nowadays. All those things are going on that way. So this is what I would say why I got diverted from passion of photography or other artworks. Thank you. See, when I was talking about change in passion, see, because of my official work and on workaholic nature, all those things I mentioned, it has a very valid reason, because when I was working in BHL and the initial stages of first 3-4 years, a new person from Delhi who got transferred to Tiruchi and who was the person doing Fortran programming with respect to engineering computer systems. Very interestingly, no? Even the computer engineering students nowadays, they will read one paper that is on evolution of computers. People used to read first generation, second generation, like that, no? And while studying, they might have read about the card, that is the card, punching of the card, and card readers, and after the dot matrix printer, and even line printers of olden days, no? How it was there, and drum printers, and tape, a very big tape like that, the hard disk and all, no? All those things, the evolution totally they might have read through in their academic studies of computer engineering. But if you see in my life, when I joined BHL that time, I have gone through all those evolution of computers. We had no monitors. Can you imagine that? Without monitor only, we used to even write all the programming and programming coding sheets. There you will find 80 columns, and one by one we will write. In eighth column only the program will start. So my life started with using punch cards and punching the cards, and card reader will read what you have written in your this thing, and always you will get a printout of what you have written as a program. From that printout only you will find it, whether A equal to B means whether equal to is there or something else is there, or A equal to C instead of B, if C is there, then you have to punch another card and keep it there for next reading. Like that, no, the lifestyle of doing the programming, and the programming further making it into an executable version of the program was taking lot of time, but it was interesting for me at that age of my 21 or so when I joined BHL. So my portion started with the Fortran programming. Of course, I stood first in that batch when they conducted one examination in BHL itself on Fortran. Then with that interest, I had been doing lot of Fortran programming, and it got, then later we got one Gino F, something like, then plotter with the ballpoint type of thing. Nowadays we do lot of printings with engineering drawings and all, no? It was not that time, that we have been using only single pens, no? Even for plotting. So the OS what we had, even basic language itself was operating system language for some time. Then we had Unix machine where shell programming and all we used to do for all these things. And you know, for your interest, I'll tell you, there will be separate job cards, and you will find certain portion of programming, and for running the program, what job which has to do first and second, like that. And you will find data cards also. You will find your data also as cards only, and program also at cards only, and the job executing the program and using the data, all those things, you know, for everything you will find card only. So a batch of card kept in a big box used to be carried towards the EDP, that is Electronic Data Processing Department. We used to carry from department to there and then load it onto the card reader, and it will read. And wherever card has got some problem, it will say some error in that. So after correction of all those errors, you will find a neat program got printed on a paper. And if it is okay, then you will ask the computer for executing the program. That is being done only by the operator. Operator console only will be there, and no persons in system will have any console. That was the time it started like that. After that, consoles came, and we used to have a separate console room where people used to go there. On the monitor, we used to sit, and very big keyboards will be there, and we will be doing some programming. So that time, as I told you, BASIC was sometime as background thing. Operating system, used ICL computer system at that time in BHL. Then after that, we had experience of using Unix language from that. And basically the language will be, one is on Fortran, high level language for engineering programs, and COBOL is a language for business development. Even in accounts package, salary package, everything were done only in COBOL, and even probably I think in some of the countries they still rely upon COBOL only, mainframe COBOL only for as far as the financial respected functioning. Of course payroll system and all, people still running with COBOL, that's what I hear from the people. See, after doing all those things in engineering system, I got transferred into materials management system. I learnt COBOL in that area. So that time we got a sufficient number of terminals in the department itself, and that time PC was not there. I think it was somewhere in 1980, 82, 84, something like that. PC XT came and AT came, and after that PCs next versions started coming, and of course clouding and all were not there. And even a network of computers and LAN network and all came later only. Only the mainframe will have different consoles connected with the mainframe computer. But after that we had all this personal computing. And of course when I was in materials management system, that time I had an opportunity to convert all the COBOL programs into Oracle modules. Oracle was introduced. We had even reporting program in 3.0 version and then 4.5, and in front end we had the developer 2000, and in back end Oracle database, relational database management system. I also remember when I am telling about this RDBMS, I remember even in COBOL itself we had that integrated system, IDBMS we used to say. Integrated Database Management System. That was one of the interesting program. I also remember that I got passed one of the Computer Society of India's examination in COBOL, All India exam. I think I came second or third in India, All India level. And after that, no, as I tell you about all these things, now you can appreciate that why I got totally shifted into that syndrome, and where I didn't even bother about the family and my kids and how to make them to a better level. And in RDBMS Oracle, I had a very good exercises, and I had my own MCA people to work under me. And of course, I myself has done lakhs of coding in PLSQL and ProC. C was the front end program for. See, taking data from Oracle, it will build up all the printing programs, or say purchase order printing or inquiry printing, offer printing, all those things we used to do in front with the C language. So that we used to say Pro C, even Pro COBOL also we did, and Pro Fortran also we did. So that was an interesting period, and we had little of course web programming also. HTML, that was the initial stage, and we had developing tools also in web development. Even in if you see in Word itself, it had its own opportunity that you build up everything in that page, then you convert into HTML, it will convert and give you, and we will do some changes here and there, and inserting some of the pick up codings from say probably C coding or whatever. Okay, so that way I had a very interesting period of spending time heavily on systems area. It was interesting, and after that only I got transferred to training sector. So training sector, of course I had enough time to execute things through the people, and that's how I would say my official life went on like this. In my 40 years of working in the same company, Bharat Heavy Electricals, right from 1977 to 2017 March, it was the longest period. Probably you may wonder, working in the same company for 40 years, starting my career as a design assistant supervisor and retiring as a deputy general manager. That was the total period, and major period spent on system area. and many portion on some of the portion in marketing, commercial, budgeting, like that. So I thought when I am telling all this, I feel okay, but I have spent little on my kids development. That's where I feel slightly guilty on that part. Somehow this took major portion of my mind. Anyway, this is what I wanted to express.